Angel Tree was an experience to share who God is by being Jesus' hands and feet. And I think I say that because we went into, it was easy to walk into someone's home that may have not had a relationship with God, but felt, I guess, a chance to get to know who God was.
I've gone from the beginning to the end. Beginning of Angel Tree is going to the prison, asking the prisons to sign up for Angel Tree, and a lot of them do. The second part is calling the families of the prison, talking to them, and asking them, have they ever heard of Angel Tree? And some of them said, yes, they have, because the prison mate had already told them about it. And they were expecting a call from us. So I've gone to the prison, called the family about it, and also, when you put up the Angel Tree, picking our name from the tree. And my family's also gone to buy the gift together. And then the other part is just wrapping the gift. But the best part of the Angel Tree is delivering the presents to the child.
So I think it's important not just to buy the gift, but to like deliver it, because we went to like deliver the gift. Harmony, like we like opened the door, and then Harmony came in. She like gave us all a hug, and she didn't know who we were. And it was super sweet, and it was just super like fun for us to play with them.
We have so much fun as a family to distribute presents. It's a blessing for us, you know. And my son can participate, and he pass out the presents, and he meet with kids with similar age.
I think we start by like picking out which kid we wanna, you know, give gifts to, and then Aaron will always pick out like a teenager, you know, because usually a girl, and there's like, you know, they want makeup and she knows makeup, so she'll try to get things like that for them, and then the boys will do someone who's their age. So I think that is just the whole process is kind of exciting. They pick out someone that, you know, that they want to give to. Erin actually paid her own money to buy the gifts, which, you know, for me, that was, you know, just a really good feeling that she wants to give her money.
Well, this is the first time for me, and even though I didn't know nothing about it, it was surprised that the people was very receptive to the Word of God and to pray.
Specifically, we prayed with one family that recently also lost her father, and we were able to pray together and empathize, and she's been in my prayer since.
I was reluctant to get involved too much with Angel Tree because maybe because I wasn't sure what to expect, and the reactions I would get, and maybe I was afraid of rejection from the family, but I did not put it in my heart to personally deliver these presents. But because I did it as a favor for a friend, it's a blessing in disguise, because I totally relied on God.
You know, by the time or after the meeting with the family, their mood changes because they're blessed that we met the family, and they know and they learn the true meaning of Christmas. It's not about receiving, but it's about always giving.
We bless so many people by doing Angel Tree that we don't even know. Relatives of the family, the parents, just so many different people are affected by what we do. Such a small thing and easy for us to do, to go to the store and get a gift. But to these kids, it means so much just to know and hear that their parents are still, you know, their moms and dads are still thinking of them and loving them regardless of where they're at.
It's a blessing for us. It tells a story of God's love to these children and God's love for us as well.